Hello friends, how are you? I hope you are fine. This video is the third part of the chapter The Necklace. Already two parts we have discussed in previous videos. Now in this video, we are going to discuss the remaining part of the chapter. Let's continue with it. Loisel detained her. Wait, said he. I am going to call a cab. Now, the wife was very, very eager to leave the place, the party, because she has wrapped herself in a shawl or in some cloth which was giving him the appearance of being poor. Other ladies, they were wrapped themselves in rich furs, but she does not have any rich fur to wrap herself. So with the fear of being seen by other people, she wanted to run away from the party. So she started moving. But Loisel, her husband told that, wait, don't go, I'm going to call a cab. But she would not listen and descended the steps rapidly. She started moving down the steps. When they were in the street, they found no carriage and they began to seek for one, hailing the coachman whom they saw at a distance. For a long time, they stood on the road, but they could not find any carriage, any vehicle to go to home. After some time, they saw the coachman at a distance and they started calling them. They started shouting. They walked along towards the river, hopeless and shivering. Finally, they found one of those old carriages that one sees in Paris after nightfall. They started shouting for the coachman, but nobody came. So ultimately, they have to go on foot. So they started moving towards the river and they were shivering also because it was winter season. Finally, they found one of those old carriages. When they reached till the river side, they found the old carriages which were found in the Paris after the nightfall. It took them as far as their door and they went wearily up. Wearily means they were very tired because it was already very late at night, to their apartment. So the carriage dropped them to the house and then they went upstairs into their apartment. It was all over for her. And on his part, he remembered that he would have to be at the office by 10 o'clock. Now, there was no issue with the wife, but the husband had to go to the office in the morning. And as he entered in the house, he immediately remembered that it is too late at night. And again, I have to get up at in the morning and I have to be ready at till 10 o'clock. She removed the wraps from her shoulders before the glass. Glass means the mirror. She stood in front of the mirror and she started removing the wraps, the cloths which were wrapped around her body, for a final view of herself in her glory. Now she was thinking that I am looking very beautiful, I am having a charming appearance. So she started looking at herself in the mirror. Suddenly she uttered a cry. Her necklace was not around her neck. When she was standing in front of the mirror, she noticed that there was no necklace around her neck. It was missing. So she shouted loudly with fear. Loisel, already half undressed, asked, "What is the matter?" Now both were changing their dress, but suddenly in between, the wife shouted. So the husband came and asked, "What is the matter?" He was also afraid. She turned towards him excitedly. I no longer have Madame Forester's necklace." But she told that I shouted because I could not find the necklace on my body which I have brought from Madame Forester. He arose in dismay. Dismay means he was also very sad. "What? How is that? It is not possible." So he was surprised to listen to this and he told that, "How is it possible? You just check it again." And they looked in the folds of the dress, in the folds of the cloak, in the pockets, everywhere. They could not find it. Everywhere, all around the dresses, they searched. They also searched in their pockets, but they were not able to find the necklace. He asked, "You are sure you still had it when we left the minister's house?" So the husband asked the wife that, "Are you sure that when we left the party, it was still on your around your neck?" Yes, I felt it as we came out. I have not touched the necklace, but I can feel the weight of the necklace around my neck when I came out from the party. But if you had lost it in the street, we should have heard it fall. It must be in the cab. So, I think that if the necklace had fallen in the street on the road, at least the noise of falling the necklace should have reached our ears. But we could not listen any such noise. So, maybe the necklace must be fallen in the cab, in the taxi in which we came. Yes, it is possible. Did you take the number? So the wife also told, yes, it may be possible that it has fallen in the cab. Do you know the number of the cab? No. And you, did you notice what it was? No. So both they asked each other that if anybody has noted the number of the cab, but no one has noted it. They looked at each other, utterly cast down. Finally, Loisel dressed himself again. The husband and the wife, they were both looking at each other in a way of shocking manner, in a surprising manner, and also in a frightening manner. And again, Loisel dressed himself. I am going, he said, over the track where we went on foot to see if I can find it. So he told that I am going back to the same route from which we came, so that at least if it has fallen down, I can see it. And he went. She remained in her evening gown, not having the force to go to bed. Now, she was not ready to sleep also because of that tension. So she sat at one place in her evening gown. Towards 7 o'clock, her husband returned in the morning. At 7 o'clock, the husband came back to the house. He had found nothing. He could not find the necklace. He went to the police and to the cab offices and put an advertisement in the newspapers offering a reward. So what the last option left was to go to the police station and to give the details of the necklace, so that anyone finds the necklace, that person can return it to him, and in return he will give the reward. So he has also given the advertisement of the necklace in the various cab offices. She waited all day in a state of bewilderment. Bewilderment means confusion. Before this frightful disaster, Loisel returned in the evening, his face pale. He had discovered nothing. Now, till the evening, both the husband and the wife, they were waiting for any kind of news, if any person comes and returns the necklace. But nothing such happened. And the face of the husband was also looking very pale because of nervousness. He said, write to your friend that you have broken the clasp of the necklace and that you will have repaired it. That will give us time. So the husband told to her that you write a letter to your friend from whom you have borrowed the necklace, and write into the letter that some part is missing of the necklace, so I have to get it repaired. So it will take some time to return back the necklace to you. In this way, we will get some time to search the necklace. She wrote as he dictated. At the end of a week, they had lost all hope. And Loisel, older by 5 years, declared, we must replace this jewel. For 1 week, they waited for any kind of news or information from anyone, but they did not get any news or information. So at the end of the week, they decided that we have to purchase another necklace from the jeweler's shop, the same looking like this one. In a shop of the Palace Royal, they found a chaplet of diamonds, which seemed to them exactly like the one they had lost. So ultimately, they went to the jeweler's shop, and there they saw a diamond necklace, which was looking like the one which was lost. It was similar like that only. It was valued at 40,000 francs. They could get it for 36,000. So both they asked to the jeweler that what is the cost of this necklace. So the jeweler told that it is 40,000 francs. But after bargaining, he was ready to give it in 36,000 francs. Loisel possessed 18,000 francs, which his father had left him. Now, from the property, he had 18,000 francs at the present. He borrowed the rest. The remaining amount means 18 plus 18, 36. So the remaining 18,000 francs he borrowed from someone. He made ruinous promises, took money and the whole and gave it to the lenders that he is going to return it back. So he borrowed the money, and when he borrowed the money, He gave them the particular time that within that time I'll return you back the money. Then he went to get the new necklace, depositing on the merchant's counter 36,000 francs. After making the arrangement of 36,000 francs, he went back to the jeweler's shop and gave that amount to the jeweler or the merchant and took the necklace. When Madame Loisel took back the jewels to Madame Forestier, the latter said to her in a frigid tone, "You should have returned them to me sooner, for I might have needed them." So, what she told? When she went to return back the jewelry, so Madame Forestier told that you are very late in returning this jewelry to me. You should have returned back it earlier, because maybe I require. Madame Forestier did not open the jewel box as Madame Loisel feared she would. What she would think if she would perceive the substitution? What she should say? Would she take her for a robber? Now, Madame Loisel has returned back the necklace by keeping it in a jewel box. But Madame Forestier did not open the jewel box to see the necklace, to check her necklace. So, Madame Loisel was afraid that if she opened the jewel box and she finds that this is not her necklace, it is a substitute of it, what she would think? Maybe she would think that I am a robber, I have stolen her necklace. Madame Loisel not knew the horrible life of necessity. She did her part, however, completely heroically. It was necessary to pay this frightful debt. Now they have borrowed the money from someone. So it is but obvious that they have to pay back the money. Now in order to pay back the money, they had made many changes in their lives. Means their whole life was changed because of this necklace. What they did? They sent away the maid. There was a maid who was working in their house. So now Madame Loisel was doing everything, each and every household work by herself. She has removed the maid. They changed their lodgings. Their house also they changed. They rented some rooms in an attic. They took the rooms on rent, which was more cheaper than the previous one. She learned the odious work of a kitchen. Till now, she was not working in the kitchen. Neither she was cooking food. So, after discharging the maid, she learned how to work in the kitchen. She washed the dishes, the utensils. She washed the soiled linen, their clothes and dishcloths, which she hung on the line to dry. Means, now she even washed her clothes and the clothes of her husband. She took down the refuse to the street each morning and brought up the water, stopping at each landing to catch her breath. Now she had to cover some distance to bring the water also. Directly the water was not available at their house. And clothed like a woman of the people, she went to the grocers, the butchers and the fruiters with a basket on her arm, shopping, haggling to the last sou of her miserable money. So she herself went to the market. Till now the maid used to go to the market to purchase the things, but now she herself has to go to the market, even to the grocer's shop, butcher shop, fruit seller shop, by taking the basket in her arms. And whatever she purchased from the market, she tried to save her money as possible as she can. The husband worked evenings, putting the books of some merchants in order, and nights he often did copying at 5 sous a page. Now the husband also had to work hard to earn the money, so he used to do the double shift. He worked in the evenings, putting the books of some merchants in order. He worked in some shop. His job was to put the books in order in proper arrangement. And nights he often did copying at 5 sous a page. And this life lasted for 10 years. He also worked for the whole night. And this type of life, both the husband and wife led for 10 years. At the end of 10 years, they had restored all. After working hard for 10 years, they were able to pay the money which they have borrowed from their friends. Madame Loisel seemed old now. Now, because she was very hard worker, she used to do each and every household work, and her diet was also not proper. So she was looking quite older, quite elder than she was. She had become a strong, hard woman, the crude woman of the poor household. Her hands had become very hard, very rough. Her hair badly dressed, her skirts awry, her hands red, she spoke in a loud tone and washed the floors with large pails of water. Sweeping also she had to do herself because no maid was there at her home. Her dress up was also very poor. Her hair was also not properly combed. But sometimes when her husband was at the office, she would seat herself before the window and think of that evening party of former times, of that ball where she was so beautiful and so flattered. Now when the husband was busy in the office and she was alone at home, she used to sit in front of the window and she used to think of the party, that how happy, how enjoyable she was feeling in that party and how the life has changed after coming from the party, and that was only because of the necklace. So you can see that the whole story is revolving around the necklace only. The remaining part of the story we will do in the fifth part of the video. Thank you.